And we had a talk within the state of pay-to-play, and then the NCAA ruled to unanimously agree to explore options, to just the biggest load of bull.
A.K.A., okay, I guess we're going to have to do this because all these states are going to start doing it.
It is the sports equivalent of the impeachment inquiry that just started. And stick to sports. Had to say that because it's funny.
It reminds me of a relationship, you know?
It's dying. And they're saying, no, I'll do what you want to do on Friday nights now. Please. That's what's happening.
Well, I was going to say it's like, you know what? Yours was better. I'm not even going to try to top that.
So that's what it is. It is the NCAA. Amateurism should have died in 1992 when they let pros in the Olympics, because the only reason from the 1920s until the 1990s to have amateur status was to be eligible for the Olympics.
Yeah.
And once that wasn't needed anymore, the NCAA just held on to it and nobody really said anything because we didn't really know what was going to happen with it and how big college sports were going to be revenue-wise, even in the early 90s.
I think it's just one of those things where it's like, well, I guess nobody else is going to do anything about it. I guess we'll just keep running it and keep doing it.
Well, there's no competition. It is sports are one of the only places in America where you can legally have a monopoly and not be challenged.
Yeah, like the NFL.
You know, Facebook is being investigated by our government right now, but the NCAA has owned collective college sports for 100 years. Realistically,
150 years.
Realistically, you're right. Three minor conferences could say, you know what, we're going to start our own thing and have their own nonprofit and say, you know, we're just not a part of the NCAA and do their completely own thing, which would cripple the NCAA once that happened. Mm-hmm. But we'll see. The NCAA will be crippled one way or another. They're over $1 billion making nonprofit entity that will be crushed.
I think they're living on borrowed time, because I think it just goes down to, I mean, even the fact that
the toothpaste out of the tube.
Well, yeah, especially the fact that California passed it, where they're just saying, you know,
and
what?
They're threatening them nonstop.
And we're just saying, hey, we're not going to abide by your rules anymore. And we're going to, this is how it's going to be. And that was the like light bulb moment where everybody else was like, we can do that.
That was the snowball that you roll down from the top of a mountain.
Because finally somebody stepped up and challenged them.
Now the avalanche is starting.
And now that they did that, now they are being forced to change their ways, which is something we should have done a while ago. But
they're going to hold on to all that they are exploring is making money off of your likeness, which
I'm fine with. That's what
okay.
It should be.
Yeah, they don't need to be paid. They don't need to be paid if they're making money. They're making money on the side, like people are saying. They are still getting scholarships. So I mean,
right?
But that's what I want.
But now they don't have time to work, so they don't have time to pay any to make any money at all.
So if every athlete gets a base pay, I would say get rid of scholarships.
Okay, but then yeah.
But if you're keeping it as likeness, you have to keep the scholarships.
But then think about this:
your long snapper's not making any money.
You're right, but
about this: offensive linemen aren't going to make any money.
Clemson's no longer going to be a juggernaut if there's no scholarships. Because Clemson's tuition is going to be double what everyone else is because they're a private school.
Right.
Good point. Private schools.
You can't get rid of scholarships.
Private schools might actually be very hurt once this really gets determined. That's a great point.
It's not
Brandon.
Just Clemson, but yeah, Notre Dame.
What about Miami?
Yeah, Notre Dame. Like, people would still go to Notre Dame, but like.
Miami's a private school.
Oh.
But yeah.
BYU.
They're going to be.
TCU. All these religious schools are going to get hit.
They're going to be double the tuition. That's just how private schools work for everyone except for the guys getting to go.
Right.
On scholarship.
Right. Northwestern will have even more white defensive backs.
Correct.
Which is, that's going to put a big wrench into the Big Ten and change the landscape of the Big Ten West. So.
I'm okay with it because it means Baylor will drop to where they should be, at least.
Oh, yeah. I had no idea they were religious.
Baylor, school. TCU, SMU. Yeah.
But then it makes sense because it's a private school, because we had this joke earlier about it's oh man, it's named after the person that created it.
Well, they're the Baptist University.
SMU would get hurt.
And SMU's Methodist and TCU is
Christian.
Yeah, but I think it is a denomination. And I think it's Presbyterian, but I'm not
sure.
We're
getting into the weeds. The point is, let's stop pretending that we don't the thing that we the only real thing that matters, we could be getting another NCAA.